And then in Kodaikanal, I'm not narrating in a chronological order, just as thoughts come to me in a random way, I am picking up and sharing with you. Kodaikanal, usually Swami gets down around 7:45 or 8 o'clock in the morning for breakfast. That being cold place, he'll tell all the boys, get ready, 8 o'clock breakfast. That being the first visit, I don't know the schedule and all that. But I'm used to hot cup of coffee, 5:30 or 6 o'clock. That's my style of life. But 8 o'clock is the breakfast time, by which time I'll have 2 or 3 rounds ready. What to do? First visit. I do not know Swami how he takes it. So I went into the kitchen, made friendship with cooks. Arey, how are you? Where do you come from? What's family? You are working very hard, very much. To get the breakfast ready, when do you get up? They said, sir, 3:30. Why early 3:30? Sir, unless we get up at 3:30, breakfast won't be ready. How about your coffee, Ra? Sir, we make our own coffee. That's good. I'll come to you near 4:30. Give me one cup also. He said, yes, sir. This has been going on for 3 to 4 days. Getting in the kitchen, coffee, sit there like innocent boy, and share the table, breakfast. On the 5th day or 6th day, Swami called that cook. Arey, Sai Krishna, come here. His name is Sai Krishna from Anantapur campus. Come here. All of us were there. Arey, what is the breakfast time? 8 o'clock, Swami. When do you serve coffee? Along with the breakfast items, Swami. But there is one fellow who is taking coffee at 4:30, 5 o'clock in the morning. Do you think it's your grandfather's property? Why do you serve like that? I'll kick you out. That fellow cannot tell that I am doing it. And he cannot accept it. He was looking at me like that, sympathetically. Then why, all right. Without any further embarrassment, I said, Swami, I am guilty. I go to the kitchen every morning and have coffee at 5 o'clock, 4:30. Oh, I say, you take number of cups of coffee, I know, but you will become dark in complexion. Don't drink too much, he said. Of course, for this time, have it. From next time, be careful. He told the cook, whenever he comes, give him a cup of coffee. This is only to let me know that he knows, but not to cut me to size. It only shows open demonstration of his love, how he cares and how he loves. Really. And it was Isharama Day, celebrated in a grand way in Kodaikanal, Isharama Day. Isharama Day or any day. 8 o'clock is the time for Swami to get down. Lot of time. So I was not ready. I was having just a turkey towel, that's all. Nothing, no banyan, nothing whatsoever. Ready for wrestling, something like that. Suddenly the door opened. Swami came. Yem rai avataram? What is all this? I said, Swami, darshan is at 8 o'clock. Now it is 7:30. Today is Isharama Day. Therefore, I got ready. Chichi, get ready very soon. When thousands are waiting for my darshan, you are giving me your darshan. I'm not able to believe them to be true even today. Even today. I'm not able to believe them to be true. And those days, Nandanvanam, Ooty, Swami used to visit that place also. And Ooty, very cold place, particularly for me. And Swami allotted one room. This is your room. Okay. Very cold, Papam. I'll give you a blanket. Come on. He gave me one blanket. After 10 minutes, he comes again. Still cold. I'll give you some rug. And he kept. Still very cold. Some heater we'll keep. He kept. After 5 minutes, again he comes. Guntoru, what to do? Hot fire. Very cold. This is my personal shawl. My personal, made up of feathers. Very soft, very nice. It has got the picture of a deer and also trees on that. A cream color shawl with these pictures on. Come on, Anil Kumar, you lay down. And then he kept the shawl. How are you? It'll be warm enough. Good night, sir, he said and left the room. How am I to believe them to be true? Will those moments be repeated any time in 1,000 lives to come? Are they true at all? Is it all a myth or a fiction? Is that a reality? That's what I believe. Every day, Swami used to give something or other to boys. It was the first time I saw chocolates of the type of American dollars. First time for me to see that. Gold wrapper, silver wrapper, dollars. Very good. Then I kept them there in the bag. Next day, Cadbury jacket. I kept in the bag. Whatever he gives, storage. One day he said, when I'm giving, distributing sweets, some fellow is not eating. Are boys, search all the suitcases. Search, open the bed sheets. Swami, no trouble, Swami, I'm not eating. Why? Why don't you eat? You don't like sweets? You don't like Swami's prasadam? Why don't you eat? Swami, I have children at home. When you carry these things and tell them that these are the gifts from Baba, the children will be very happy, Swami. For them I am carrying, I am not eating here. Then Baba said, just as you would be happy as your children eat, I'll be happy if you eat in front of me. Since that day, he started giving every sweet, every peppermint, every chocolate. Four for children, one for my immediate consumption in the divine presence. See what love it is. I don't think to have been loved by my people as much as Baba himself. Yes. It's beyond our estimation, beyond our imagination. The tender care, the loving care, and the personal attention. They were all like that. And there, we have to take boys around the lake in Kodaikanal, 6 kilometers in width. And we should return as early as possible, because Swami will complete his giving interviews to devotees and will be waiting for boys. So we come there. That day I was late. He started cutting joes with boys already. I came there. Anil Kumar, what happened to you? Swami, I am late. Are all know that you are late. I am asking, why are you late? I said, Swami, I had been to post office. Are, did I not tell you that he went to post office? All the boys laughed. Because Swami gave cricket commentary, what all I did there. Cricket commentary. What do you do in the post office? You'll have lunch or dinner there. Swami, what do we do in post office after all? I wrote a letter. Array, did I not tell you that he's writing? To whom did you write? Divine elicitation of information is topmost in eliciting information from people. Top members of the organization know it pretty well. That's how we are caught. Slowly. Swami, I wrote a letter to my wife. Are boys, did I not tell you? What did you write? What do you write to your wife? So I'm relating to her what all that is happening here and how blessed we are, how happy we are. Manchi, manchi. Avunu, mana pillalni post cheyamanochu kada? Em neevenduku akkada undipoyinavu? You would have asked our boys to post the letter. Why should you stay there? Then he said, my boys are not your Guntur boys. They're all rowdies. My boys are different. They don't open the letters and read. You understand? You would ask them to post it. Ah, okay, Swami, thank you, I'm sorry. That's what I said. So, these are all the very, very interesting things. Very interesting things.